years old, I had sat on my bed and I looked down at my thighs and they looked big to me. It was actually when I was 11 years old that it really hit me that I didn't want to eat anymore.
It kind of started when I was 12. It was kind of stupid. I was brushing my teeth and I stuck a toothbrush down my throat and accidentally made myself throw up. And I was like, wow, that's kind of weird. So from like 12 to 15, I kind of played around with that. What the number on the scale says affects how my entire behavior is the whole day. If the number's lower than the day before, then I have a good day. If the number's higher than the day before, then I have a bad day. It's just like everything.
It affects everything from like when I go to work, and I work at a mall, so sometimes I forget my lunch and I have to eat in the food court, which is really hard because the food's greasy, but if I go and I eat at the food court and then I want to purge afterwards.
Eating disorders in general are very solitary. You're always alone because you don't want to go up to, you know, your closest friend and be like, oh my god, I didn't eat today, because they're not going to like that. They're going to be like, well, you need to eat, and you don't want them to do that. It's like, you kind of want the attention, but you don't.
I isolate. I completely shut everyone off, and I just don't want to be around people. So it affects my friendships and how I'm there for people or how they're there for me. I don't usually let people be there for me.
You're constantly struggling with it. You're always thinking about it. So your relationships with people are usually not as truthful as you'd like them to be because you're always hiding something from them. We're really supportive of each other, but we won't let the other person actually support us. It's kind of weird and twisted. Like, we want to help each other and we know the other person's trying to help us, but it's really hard to take that help from them.
There is hope. You may not ever be fully recovered. You're always probably going to fall back. You're always going to relapse, but there is control that you can take back. So if you just sit down and you empower yourself every day and tell yourself that you can do it and you can make it through, then I think that you can definitely get past the hurdle of like it being controlling your life every day. You're always gonna have setbacks, but there's hope. It's basically the advice we can give.